Welcome. Oh, my goodness. Welcome, everybody, to our production of Legally Blonde. My name is Ben Nicioli. I'm the co-president of the Drama Club, along with Megan Artis.
And I'm Evan Vandenbroek, the co-vice president, along with Cecilia Michelli.
First things first, we'd like to ask you all to please turn off all electronic devices. They interfere with the microphones, and we don't want that to happen. Also, please note flash photography is very rude, and it is a distraction to the actors on stage.
At the end of Act 1, there will be a 15-minute intermission in which you can go out into the lobby, get refreshments, and use the restrooms. Please note that no food or beverages are allowed back into the auditorium.
There are a number of people we'd like to thank for putting this show on tonight, including the directors, the musicians, the choreographers, but we'd also like to thank the GB administration and the GBHSPAA board. Thank you guys so much for what you do.
Now, you might have noticed out in the hallway the empty seat and the plaque dedicating it. Please feel free to check out the history and reason behind it when you have time.
Now, we all know there's a playoff football game tonight, so if anyone's interested, we do keep updates, about the game during the intermission. Also, please support our football team afterward by watching them. It's pretty far so far in the playoffs, so if you support them, that's pretty awesome.
Songs from our winter and spring musicals, Evita and A Chorus Line.
Thank you. Thank you.
want you to know how happy you've made me. I mean, every guy dreams of finding a girl who looks like you.
We both know why we're here. I see it in your eyes. I guess it calms my fear to know it's not a surprise. But one look at you, looking like a dream come true, would leave me speechless like you always do. But now we're wide awake. We've got some plans to make. Let's take some action, baby. So baby, give me your hand. I've got some dreams to make true. I've got the future all planned. It's time to get serious. Time to get serious with you.
I
was 2 or 3. My life was planned out neat. I'd get my law degree and then win my Senate seat. A big White House back east, all of the amenities. Three kids at least, just like the Kennedys. Here's where our lives begin. But just where you fit
in.
I'll break it down now, baby. I've got some dreams to make true.
We got the dreams to make true.
I know that you'll understand.
Oh, yes, I understand.
It's time to get serious. Time to get serious with serious. Time to wake up and take our future serious. I'm telling you, as a future attorney, you want the moon sky. They tell you, don't be shy. Baby, that's why you and I.
About that, Pooh Bear, but they expect a lot from me. I'm going to Harvard Law School, and my brother's at Yale Law, and so is his new wife, and come on, she's a Vanderbilt, for Christ's sake.
Okay, so I'm not good enough for you? Warner, I'm from Malibu. I'm not exactly trailer trash here. Richard Simmons is my neighbor.
Elle, if I'm gonna be a senator when I'm 30, I'm gonna need somebody serious. Less of a Marilyn, more of a Jackie. Serious. Somebody classy and not too tacky.
What?
Okay, that came out wrong.
No.
Baby, let's both be strong. I mean, we've known all along.
Just shut up. What does that mean, I'm not a Jackie? I'm not serious, but I am seriously in love with you.
Baby, my future's all planned. I've got some dreams to make true. I thought that you'd understand. It's time to get serious. Time to get serious. Check, please.
More than Town and Country and Elle to bring. bring me back from my shame spiral.
Well then, sweetie, you're just gonna have to hold on, because my new Cosmo's not out till next week.
Oh.
What? Don't tell me ponchos are back in.
No, worse.
It's Warner's brother, Peyton Huntington IV, and his bride, pictures from their wedding. Look!
Muffy Vanderbilt.
Muffy?
Wait a second. This is the kind of girl Warner wants. Someone serious. Someone lawyer. Someone who wears black, even when nobody's dead. Girls, I have a completely brilliant plan.
And that's how I'll survive.
Outstanding.
And now, Mr. Woods, who was kind enough to send in a headshot.
She's applying.
Apparently.
I mean, it says here she has a 4.0 average.
Yeah, and fashion merchandising.
And she scored a 175 with her LSATs.
And she has a letter of recommendation from Oprah Winfrey.
I'm not arguing. Miss Woods is entirely qualified. Look at her. Is this the face of Harvard Law?
Multiculturalism!
Excuse me?
We should admit her for reasons of,
multiculturalism.
Exactly.
Gentlemen, get a hold of yourselves. This is Harvard Law, not Match.com. Oh, look here. What a shame. She didn't even bother sending in a personal essay.
How is this for a personal essay?
Some say that I'm a pompous creep.
Somehow I don't lose that lustre. Why bother with false modesty? Harvard's the perfect place for me.
Pretty impressive, good to know. Welcome to Harvard.
What's up?
Yo!
Sandeep Pagrao Paramala, but you may call me Your Majesty. In my country, my word was law.
Myself from mud and trees, I fought to clean up their lagoons and save their rare endangered wounds and led a protest march against insensitive cartoons.
Pretty impressive,
but now I'm on the legal track because this country's out of whack and all you women have the guts to go and take it back. We'll make the government complete and get more people voting green and really stick it to the balance of your war machine.
Anything you say will be used against you. Now,
When you choose a law career the moment you embark, there is that joke you're bound to hear. A lawyer is a shark. Ignore that, it's simplistic and it's dumb. Only some of you turn out sharks, just some. The rest are chum. Our topic is blood in the water. Kids, it's time you faced. Law school is a waste. Oh yes, unless you acquire a taste for blood in the water. Dark and red and raw, you're nothing until the thrill of the kill becomes your only law. Mr. Schultz, hypothetical question. Would you defend the following banker accused of fraud? A kind old grandma took her savings and she sent it off to your client, all she saved since she was born. Well, he promised to invest it, but he spent it on prostitutes and heroin and porn.
No, I would not take that case.
Wrong. This one is a win unless you're lazy. Grandma's broke, she'll have some hack for legal aid. Put her on the stand and call her old and crazy. Your guy goes free and he can get you high. Look for the blood in the water. Read your Thomas Hobbes. Only swine with snobs will war with the more leave dubious jobs. Yes, blood in the water. Your rules are a law. Yes, Miss Coops, hypothetical question. Would you be the right lawyer to defend the following life? Say they offer you a bundle for defending a famous hitman from the mafia elite. Sing, sing, mistress, chosen prey, killed an unnamed young boy, running over three cute puppies in the street.
What? You think I wouldn't defend him just because he's a typical man?
Oh, that's really funny. Yeah, laugh it up, you lesbians think you're so tough. I said you lesbians think you're so tough. Oh dear, I fear my comment has offended. Hard to argue though when you're too mad to speak. Your employment will be very quickly ended when they see how your emotions make you weak. So it's my point to hire a $1 million law firm. And I hire 4 new interns every year. From this class, I will select for young sharks, my respect, and those four will have a guaranteed career. Do you follow me? So I want to see what exactly let the games begin. Four of you will win. But just those four with the dorsal fin. Yes, one in the water. So wait and stretch and someone's at their morning coffee. Would you summarize the case of State of Indiana v. Hearn from your reading, please?
But I wanted to answer the puppy question.
But I'm asking you about the assigned reading.
Okay, well, who assigns a reading for the first day of class?
Woo! Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
You have guts. Miss Kensington, let us say you teach a class at Harvard Law School, a position that you're justly proud about. But a girl whom you call has employed your case at all. Should you let her go?
No, I throw her out.
Huh. All right, then. Cut your throat, so grab your coat. Yes, you've got guts, but now they're spilled. Your blood in the water. So would you and if you return, be ready to learn. Or is that unfair? Oh wait, I don't care. That's just how I feel. In life is in school with fear. I'm stuck and all. You're nothing until
Yeah.
Make me a brunette.
What? A brunette? No. Honey, you're a genetic lotto win. All right, sit down. Something else is going on here. Back up. Let's listen. Still.
Okay. So Ima Woods, and I came all the way out for Harvard Law.
That's a good school.
I know, right? I did it to follow my one true love, Warner Huntington III. But now he's dating some evil preppy.
So what's she got that you don't? Three boobs?
No, she's serious.
Seriously, does she have three boobs?
No, she's a constipated polo shirt with a massive round butt. But she's what Warner wants. So you have to make me a brunette.
Whoa. Do you know the number one reason behind all bad hair decisions? Love. You lost without your love. Your heart is on the floor. I can help you. I've been there before. When I need to relax, I just put on some tracks from the CD I bought for the store.
Getting together.
together on Friday night.
How you like will be there, Elle?
We should go.
Definitely come. It's a costume party.
I love costume parties.
Of course you do. Next Friday at 8, 243 Mass Ave. See you there.
Thanks, Vivian.
Oh, Elle, you are so far when my secret weapon costume I got in storage. I'll just dust off the mothballs, what will you see? Now, you go and you do this, honey, because if a girl like you can't win that command, then there is no hope for the rest of us.
Thank you, Paula. You have no idea how much I needed this.
Now, you go and you fight for it.
Thanks, Warner. I'm completely cognizant of both of those facts. You're not going to make it through the semester.
let alone Callahan's internship. Even if you keep going and going and going. Face it, Bunny, one of these things is not like the other. Someday we'll nominate Supreme Court justices. Well, you tan. Run home, Elle, and change out your skank costume.
Oh, is that what you see? How unfortunate. Because I am Gloria Steinem, circa 1963, researching for her feminist manifesto, I was a Playboy bunny. Now, are you really calling Gloria Steinem a skank?
Who's calling Gloria Steinem a skank?
She is.
Are you serious?
Wow, you do drink a lot of red. Red Bull, don't you?
It gives me energy!
So you can stay up studying?
What?
I said studying. You do study, don't you? Where are those law books? Hardly my business to say, could it be the real thing in your way?
is the very guy you're trying to impress.
Yes.
I've been smiling and sweet and thoroughly beaten, blowing my chance. Let's not chase him away. Let's face him and say, hey, come, let's dance. He's just on my shoulder.
If she's trying to hurt him colder, no more whining or whining. I agree to play me my bride. Grab that lover, that's on the list. That's the only one I'll prove it. Yeah, there's a chip on my shoulder.
Let's see him knock it aside.
Mr. Latimer wasn't stalking. He was clearly within his rights to ask for visitation. Russell B. Sullivan.
Yes, but Russell was known to the mother. Latimer was an anonymous donor.
Well, yeah, but without Mr. Latimer's sperm, the child in question wouldn't exist.
Now, you're thinking like a lawyer. Yes, Miss Woods?
Mr. Huntington makes an excellent point. But did the defendant keep a log of every sperm emission made throughout his life?
Interesting. Why do you ask?
Because if he is not, then he has no parental claim over this child whatsoever. Why now? Why this sperm?
I see your point.
And, by Mr. Huntington's standard, all nocturnal emissions where the sperm was clearly not seeking an egg could be called reckless abandonment.
Miss Woods, you just won your case.
Oh my God.
Wait, hold on.
Substitutes.
Angelica, the best decision I ever made, throwing you out.
Can you believe I've lived with that for 10 years?
That cheating never even bought me a ring.
Wait, Elle. They lived together for 10 years.
Elliot, you're a genius.
Now what?
Mr. Dewey, sir, we are Miss Bonafante's legal team.
Lawyers?
Yes. And I'm not sure that you're aware that the Commonwealth State of Massachusetts recognizes your 10-year relationship with Miss Bonafante as a common law marriage, entitling her to equitable division of property. Huh? Translation?
We're taking the dog!
Is there my name up on that list? Does someone know that I did this? Is this a mistake?
with presents for the holiday season. In order to accomplish our goal, we have called upon the faculty, staff, and students of Dry Valley School District to assist us. However, we are also in need of your support as well. As you exit the theater for intermission, you will see students with red Santa hats holding holiday bags. These are our peer counselor donation collectors, and we are asking for you to please donate in any way possible. Some loose change, a few dollars, anything really helps. It would really mean a lot to us. Thank you all so much, and please enjoy the rest of the show.
And with a touchdown by Brennan and the extra point by Rose, Dart Valley is up 7-0. Go Jay!
Thank you. Wyndham. My name is Emmett Forrest. I'm co-counsel with Stitwell, Zykowski, Fox, and Callum. These four interns here are the cream of the crop at Harvard Law, and we're here to whip up your legal defense team. Incidentally, my mom is a huge fan of your DVDs. Credit you with her nutcracker funds. Her words, not mine. Anywho, we'd love to discuss your case and go over a few options. We want to set you free as soon as possible so we can get the word out to your fans.
That's all I want. This should be easy.
Great. Callahan briefed me on your meeting earlier, and there's a significant amount of evidence against you. In order to free you, the jury's going to need to hear an alibi.
Not gonna happen.
Although it could save you.
Yep. Put me on the stand and I'll be forced to lie.
Okay, Miss Cooper, if we can't hear an alibi, you should at least accept the plea bargain.
And admit to something I didn't do?
But with a plea bargain you get out in a couple of years, that sounds reasonable.
Reasonable to do time for my husband's killer?
Not really.
She's tough.
Yo, sister.
Yo, not related. I need a defense team who knows I'm innocent. Get out of here, all of you. Guard?
Who's the girl with loyal friends and true? Who has a bond as strong as crazy glue? Who can sound the call when sisters all come through? Delta new,
you are a Delta new. Delta new, you are a Delta new!
Delta new, former President L. Woods, I knew I recognized your mugshot!
Shut up!
Yes, you got me in shape to be the June of the UCLA Girls Calendar!
That's so great! Thank God someone on this legal team gets me!
I do, and I will do everything I can to clear your good name. But that involves an alibi.
I can't tell it.
Oh, come on. We all have secrets. For years I've been hiding my highlights.
It's beyond highlights, Al. It's a disgrace. My secret is nuclear, and if it gets out, I could lose my fitness empire, which means everything to me. If I tell you, will you Delta New Sister swear on that tell anyone?
I will double Delta New Sister swear.
You are hardcore. Okay. On the day my husband was killed, I was dead.
What? What are you saying?
What about assumption? Mentally, invasive, outpatient, life off.
Okay, everyone, field trip's over. Let's go back to work.
except for you two. I'd rather not see Ratty Corduroy or Legally Blonde.
Emmett, I'm sorry.
Oh, I don't need you to be sorry. I need an alibi.
I can't tell you. I gave her my word. We don't need the alibi.
No, but it would sure help.
We can free her the right way, the noble way.
No, this isn't a Lifetime original movie. I'm not interested in nobility. I'm more interested in saving Brooke's life.
Really? Because it seems as though you're more interested in impressing Callahan.
Well, he is my boss. Plus, if I'm present, he'll make me an associate.
And jeopardize our client's trust. And our integrity.
Okay, well, yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, well, when you put it that way.
Exactly, you butthead.
Wow. No one's called me a butthead since third grade.
Oh, maybe not to your face.
Come on, let's get out of here.
Oh,
you always have to be right.
Oh, I'm not. When I'm with you, I can just stay up. Listen, if you want to impress Callahan, I can help.
Okay, how?
Okay, so I love your scruffy vibe, but Casual Friday is so not Callahan's vocabulary. You have to dress the part if you want to get ahead.
Mel, hasn't your mother ever taught you not to judge a book by its cover?
She did, and that's why books with tattered covers stay on the shelf.
Hey, thanks!
Come on, it's a tough world out there, Emmett. You don't think I haven't gotten judged my entire life? You don't think it wasn't a good idea to make Navy my new thing?
No, that was actually a good idea.
I know.
Where are we going?
You trust me, don't you?
Of course.
Then don't stop now.
Change.
for me.
That's the best part. The outside is new, but now it reflects what's already in you. I couldn't change that if I wanted to, and I do not.
Thank you.
No, thank you. This is a gift. It's payment in kind. It's use all beyond all the lines in my mind. Oh, we pacify this. What are you blind? You look up.
I'm not
The Bennett's math is 99.99% effective on straight men.
Oh, that's great! Because I have a great track record with those.
I see the problem here, and it's not physical. It's spiritual. Paula just needs a little spirit.
And Serena knows all about spirit. She's the UCLA chair team captain!
Yes, and
shopping.
You look sharp.
Charlotte Brett.
This is day 3 of Walt Wyndham's murder trial. D.A. Joyce Riley has been grilling Nico's Arcatangos all morning. The waters could get dicey. Let's hope Red Bennett brought their flimmies.
Meaning the pool. That was my uniform.
And was it Brooks? Are you trying to wear the uniform?
Yes.
And can you please tell us where your relationship was to the defendant?
Brooke and I were lovers. Either way, if you're European.
Well, hello, Meryl. Looks like you'll really make partner now. Whew, you sure earned it.
Werner, shut up!
Thank you. consider this training a thank you for staying with me at the hospital.
Oh, please. The pleasure was all mine.
Well, I should get going now. Judy Coles.
Judy Coles? All that and she has a job? Come on, Rufus. It's time for your manager. Goodbye? What do you mean?
I'm going back home. Back to California.
To California?
Back where I make sense.
Well, you're not making any right now. Honey, what happened?
All this time I thought I was making a difference and proving to everyone that I could be more than just some blonde, dumb joke, but that's all anyone's ever gonna see.
That's not what I see.
Vivian?
Maybe Warner saw the woman who was trying to sneak her way to the top? But all I see is someone who doesn't have to.
Thank you.
But not unless she has a licensed attorney. And without me, she does not.
Actually, she does, Your Honor. I'm a licensed attorney. I will gladly supervise her.
Like hell you will. You work for me, remember?
Actually, I work for myself, and I don't have to hit on interns, Professor.
Enjoy prison.
Okay, bye.
What, do you think I was just gonna let you get away?
Miss Woods, any day now, you may proceed. Call your first witness.
We call Chucky Wyndham to the stand.
My God,
T.P.
So tragic, Burn!
Now, Miss Wyndham, what was your relationship to the deceased?
He was my father.
And did you actually see his murder take place?
No, I was in the shower. But when I got out, Rolf was standing over my father's body, drenched in his blood.
Oh, boy, we're screwed.
Don't listen to him, Elle. You're doing fine. Keep going.
Now, Miss Wyndham, on the day your father was killed, did you see anybody suspicious hanging around?
Suspiciously hanging around my father?
No, before that,
I was out getting
And then you came home and took a shower.
Yes, I was in the shower.
Your Honor, I would like to go to the bathroom.
Should you have gone before the murder trial?
I meant I would like us to go to the bathroom together.
Why do girls always do that?
No, I meant I would like us to go back to the bathroom where this alleged shower took place.
Oh, well, Miss Woods.
Seriously, I was wrong.
Thanks, Warner.
We do belong together. You've shown me who we can be. Together again.
Oh, Warner. Vivian dumped you, didn't she?
Applied to a woman, a blonde woman. For the past 3 years, she taught me and showed us all